Yeah, camera.
She wouldn't.
So, can you tell me why such a lovely lady such as yourself would be out monitoring police activity? What would compel you to do this?
Because I don't trust them to do the right thing. I used to until they did a lot of wrong things in front of me, and I saw them do it and hurt a lot of people, hurt me.
Now, are you talking about experiences during Occupy Portland?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, we were there at eviction, and I swear I was never the same again, because I just couldn't believe what I was seeing. I just thought that the police were all there to protect us and help us, and then they started beating us for no reason. And I can't ever get those sounds and images out of my head. So I come down here to deal with that and try, you know, one of the good things about this is that I see the interactions with the cops outside of Occupy are pretty mellow, pretty cool, and that's doing a lot for me to get over a lot of the PTSD that causes my heart to stop every time I see a cop car. I get a real strong, there was a cop car parked in front of my kid's school tonight when I went to see her play, and I immediately was like, didn't want to walk in the building. So this is hopefully going to help me deal with that. And plus, I just think it's brilliant. I think that the cops are definitely going to be better behaved if you got a camera on them. It's just the way people are. Human behavior. So
I'm going to ask you the same two questions I ask everybody I interview that participates with our lovely organization. First question is, what would you say to cops that do their job right, that are trying to act as a sentinel and someone who's serving the public trust and protecting our private property? What would you say to this person?
I say good for you. I mean, you've been given a really privileged role in the community, and if you take it seriously and you're really out to do good and protect people, then, I mean, I'm on your team. You know? It's that simple. That's what I think they should be doing.
Okay, thank you. And the next question is, what would you say to the bad apples, the ones that would take advantage of their privileged position?
Well, I was a bullied kid pretty fiercely, and I would say that you're cowards, and I would like to see them rot in jail. I just have no love for them.
And finally, is there anything you'd like to add?
Just be aware of what's going on around you. Don't read everything you read in the mainstream press. Do your own digging. Get involved in your community. Wake the fuck up and help out the people who are getting completely annihilated by our ridiculous culture.
Thank you.
Do your part.